As your game grows, you might find useful to customize how the inspector works. And while you can completely reinvent the inspector with add-ons, you can also make some simple but very useful changes just by overriding a few functions inside your script. The Godot inspector itself is created based on a dictionary, and using the multiple @export decorators is merely a shortcut to change them. But you can also manually do it yourself if you want to. This is not very useful yet, but it's important to know how it works. Each entry has a name, a type, an usage, and oftentimes a hint and a hint string. To get this to work, your script will need to be a tool script, and by overriding the get property list, you can return a dictionary that will be added to the class inspector. So for example, the sport category is the same as creating an entry with the type new and property usage category. And to import a float, use type float and property usage default. This will try to use the variable with that name, but you can also use any name and manually use the get and set functions to do whatever you want. You can get the full list of available property hints and usages from the docs that are filled with examples. But by doing things this way, you might realize you don't have the default reset value. That's because you need to use the property can revert to tell if the revert icon is to be shown or not. This is called with the name each property has. And then use the property get revert to set what happens when the button is pressed. The return value here is what the variable is going to be set to, the same as calling set var name with that return value. And while that is all good to know, it's usually not very useful. What is more useful is another function called validate property. This is called to validate the property, but it also lets you change the entry, including changing its type. So for example, we can make the ruins description here become a multi-line text box if it has more than 10 characters. And another very useful one is dynamic enums. Here, I have the script that takes a skeleton, and I want to choose the bone from that skeleton from a list. We can't really use the export enum here because it takes a string or an enum, and we might not have set our skeleton yet. To solve this, we need to create a validate property. And when it's validating the target bone, we check if we have a valid skeleton. If we do, we set the enum list to be the skeleton concatenated bone names, a string list of all bones. And also auto-select the first bone by setting the target bone ourselves. If we don't have a valid skeleton, then we'll remove the enum choices by clearing the hint string. And to make this perfect, we also create a setter for the skeleton. Here, we'll call notify property list changed to update the enum when the skeleton is changed. But notice that it's not working yet. That's because Godot didn't make the script a tool script yet. To fix that, you just need to reload the scene. And now the script will turn blue, indicating it's a tool script. Now we can select the skeleton to have their bones list appear in the Dropbox. And when we clear the skeleton, it will also reset. A very useful feature when working with bones or other dynamic enums. But that's it! As always, if you'd like to support me, I have a Patreon where I post little experiments and project files there. Now you can enhance your scripts to help you create and modify your script properties. I hope you liked this video, and until next time.